Good morning to all of my subscribers and potential subscribers. It is a beautiful Saturday morning, and today we are doing a clay and seal on a Dodge Ram. We're going to be taking you guys along so y'all can see the process on that. Unfortunately, today, Rob called me at about 4:30 a.m. and told me that he wasn't feeling so good, so I called an old friend that used to detail with me, and he's going to be tagging along. Before we get into the video, guys, go ahead and do me a favor. Go ahead and pause this, give me a like, give me a subscribe, and at the end of the video, if you guys like what you see, go ahead and hit that share button. All right, guys, so I'm fully dressed. I had breakfast, and now I am on my way to go pick up, I guess you can call him my backup partner. I used to detail with Caleb probably about 6 months ago was his last detail with me. He ended up getting another job somewhere else, which is cool, you know. We were kind of slow, so he went off and kind of did his own thing, and now since I guess it's Saturday morning, he's gonna come rock with me for a little bit. So I'll catch up with you guys when I pick him up, and we'll kind of go from there. All right, Caleb, say hi to the 20 million people that watch my videos.
Hello to the 25 million people that watch these videos.
No, I'm just playing. It's like 20. It's like 20 people, period.
Sorry, it'll add up eventually.
Good morning, bro. Welcome back. Welcome back. All right, so I forgot to update everybody, but we are on site right now. I got Caleb here spraying some APC on this vehicle. This is a Dodge Ram. Owner said he kind of uses it as a track car, a burnout competition vehicle and everything, so there's definitely some rubber stuck to the back fender wells. So we're just trying to break everything up really quick and then come in with the foam wash and break it up even more, and then we'll hit it with the clay and seal. And then we are going to be doing a test panel on the client's other truck to see what we can accomplish for the two-step paint correction. So now we're coming in with the clay bar, just trying to get rid of the rest of the grittiness in the vehicle. This is a Griot's Garage synthetic clay bar. I also have just kind of a one-off Amazon one that Caleb is using on the opposite side of the vehicle. He's already done. Cool thing about these ones is, if you don't already know, if you drop these ones, you don't have to throw it away. You just wash it off really quick and continue on with what you were doing. If you're using a traditional clay bar, then yes, you do have to throw it away once you drop it, unfortunately. But these ones last probably about, I could do maybe 10 or so cars, depending on how bad they are, with the contamination and everything. But yeah, we will catch up with you guys in just a second with the sealant. So we are just finishing up the tires. And then we are getting out of here after this little test spot on the Chevy. Truck's looking a lot better than before. These wheels look great. Yeah, we're going to do a test spot on the Chevy for a polish or a paint correction, a two-step paint correction. Looking a lot better. All right, so a little side quest. I just dropped Caleb off at home.
I'm going to go into my local Harbor Freight and see what kind of sales they're having right now. I do need a couple polishers because that gentleman that we just detailed for wants me to do a two-step paint correction on his other truck, and I need new polishers. Alright, I didn't film too much in there, but we ended up grabbing the Warrior polisher just because it was on a pretty good deal with Harbor Freight. Got the 2-year warranty just in case anything goes wrong. So now that polisher is going to be Rob's, and I'll stick with my Avid for now. We are going to go back to that client's house in a couple weeks and do a two-step paint correction on that jacked up Chevy in the driveway. But yeah, just a little recap because this is going to be a short video. We picked up Caleb. Went and did that Dodge Ram where we did a full wash, a decontamination, a clay bar, and then hit it with a Meguiar's sealant. But yeah, that pretty much wraps everything up, guys. Go ahead, like, share, and subscribe. We're still growing, so everything you guys can do would be much appreciated. And have a great rest of your day, guys.